first opened back in 2012. We're live inside the cavernous Lone Depot Park in Miami. Tonight, it's an NL Eastern Division showdown between the Washington Nationals and the Miami Marlins. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Pablo Lopez is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Marlins. Dan, any thoughts?
You know, Matt, he wasn't all that bad in his last one. In a day and age where we don't see a lot of complete games, six full innings in his last one, and if they can score him a few runs, he has a chance to win this one here today.
So now here is number 81. He'll get us started in this one under the lights.
The left fielder, number 81.
First pitch on its way. A high fastball is in there. Guys, this Marlins ball club, as they begin play here tonight, despite the loss last time out, they'd won four in a row, so they've been on a nice little roll here.
Yeah, Matty V. Hey, D-Row, we're looking at a team that's playing some pretty good baseball right now. Through the first five games of this homestand, 4-1, and looking for some bigger and better things.
Yeah, we had a chance to sit down before the game after BP with the manager. He was really pleased with the way his team has played in these last five.
One ball,
let's see if it continues today.
One ball and two strikes to count. A very warm 85 degrees as we begin play tonight. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes.
Two balls.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the ropes, but now he let him right back into this at bat.
Now the payoff pitch home. Skied down the left field line. Duvall has him played perfectly as he puts it away for route number one.
Batting second, the center fielder, number 16, Victor Robles.
Next, here is Victor Robles. His prior history versus this arm, he's gone just 2-for-15. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
Ball one, no strike.
Bases are empty, one man out. Two and zero to the Nationals center fielder. Lopez has thrown a little over 150 innings of work so far, and through those innings he's worked to a whip under 1.20. League average is around 1.3, so that's a respectable number. Look out.
Three balls.
All over the place now. 3-0. Three and one.
He must know something we don't know. That was a center cut heater with count leverage in a big spot. I don't understand why he's taking.
Line drive to center field, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
3-1 fastball, middle cut, and he didn't miss it. That's the fight throughout the course of the game to get yourself into count leverage and capitalize.
Here now is Trey Turner as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. And he's carrying a batting average of just over 300. So clearly he's been a productive player with the bat in his hand so far. Throw over to first and the runner back. Robles leads off first with one away. And again a throw, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. Here it comes, 1-0.
Yeah, I get it. They want to run this guy's pitch count up, but that was a pretty good pitch to hit. He might be kicking himself that he didn't swing at that one.
Now a throw over, and he'll get back in safely. Runners on first with one down. Fastball called strike. 1-2. And he won't go after the cut fastball. 2-2.
I got to count. 2-2.
From the belt, the pitch fouled off. Fastball laid off well below the knees.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the runner moving here on that 3-2 pitch. With only one out, but this guy at the plate swings the bat really well, so it's likely he'll put the ball in play if it's a pitch worth swinging at.
Now the payoff pitch home. Gets him looking. Strike three.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
Josh Bell the next to hit. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. Throw over to the bag, and the runner will get back standing. Two out, base runner aboard in the top of the first. And another throw over. The 1-0 home. Pitch out, nothing doing. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul.
That's
3-1.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like and drive it right now.
The 3-1. Back up the middle and in for a base hit.
Hey, maybe we have something brewing right here. That has to be the case. When you're facing an elite-level A starter, numero uno, you have to find a way to get to him. Any chance you get, maybe this is their opportunity early.
And that'll bring up Josh Harrison as he'll look at a changeup that drops below the knees for ball one. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. Short. And the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. Nats leave a pair. Now the Marlins will see what they can do. No score. Patrick Corbin gets the starting assignment for the Nats in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, this guy's had a solid season up to this point. 15 wins on the year, and that's a pretty good number. He's going to look to add to that total in this one here today.
Stepping up is Jazz Chisholm. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And now a pitch on the way. This he'll watch a slider that runs out of the strike zone away for ball one. So, guys, these Nationals, as they interplay here tonight, they've been playing some pretty good baseball of late as they've won six of their last eight games.
Hey, thanks, Matty. Hey, you know what, D-Roll? Try to get on a kind of a little mini winning streak here. Losing the first game of this series, winning game two, and hopefully winning this series by pulling one out here today.
Yeah, Dan, they were able to shower that first loss off in the first game of this series and had a nice bounce back game yesterday. Yeah. Let's see if they can steal the series right here.
Two balls and a strike to count. The 2-1 grounder down the line at third.
That's a great sinker right there. These batters are going to have to bear down, because if he's got that good pitch working, it's going to be a long game. They might have to sit off speed.
Full count now. And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game.
Well, he gives up the walk, but that was a really good pitch. Might have been just out of the zone, but not by much. A lot of guys would have gone fishing for that pitch, so sometimes the hitter just outlasts you.
First delivery to him in the dirt, and he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there, and forget about the double play now, as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, now might be a good time to make a visit to the mound. Your pitcher walks the first batter and allows him to get into scoring position with the wild pitch. Got to settle him down and make sure everything's all right physically.
1-0 pitch on the way. Hit out towards second, and that's the first down.
That is good. The center fielder, Mike Trout.
And that'll bring Mike Trout to the dish. Here it comes. Hit softly on the ground at third. Harrison's got to get rid of it, and indeed he'll take only the out at first as the run comes in to score.
That is really good team at bat right there, right? Just put the ball in play. He does just that, gets the ground ball, and brings home the first run of the game from third.
Set to go now, Nicholas Castellanos, as he's been in a pretty good stretch over the last 10 or so ball games. First pitch on its way.
That's a ball.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Now the 1-0 is in there for strike one. Hit to first. Bell picks it up. Over to first, and that retires the side. Gotta love a night at the ballpark. These fans certainly are. The three of us return with more Wednesday Night Baseball after this. New inning set to get underway, and standing in is the veteran outfielder,
Hernan Perez.
Now here's the first offering. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. A ball and a strike. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is James Kingsley.
Hey, D-Row, James Kingsley's a pretty good umpire. He doesn't get too excited, keeps things under emotions. He's a pretty good ball and strike umpire.
Yeah, James Kingsley will never show you up, and he's always approachable.
There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Back goes Trout at the track. A leap, and he's got it. Impressive play for the first down.
The second baseman, Carter
Keboom.
Now at the plate, Carter Keboom. In his career against this pitcher, just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. The windup and the 0-1. And that misses 1-1. Well thrown sinker that time, down but in the strike zone. Here comes the 1-2. Hit hard on the ground to second, reined in, and there's out number two. Set to get his evening at the plate started, Mac James, trying to get it going at the plate. It's been tough sledding for him so far this year. And now the first pitch. And a high strike to begin the at bat. It's 0-1.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Nationals gone in order. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Bottom of the inning now, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Garrett Cooper.
Garrett Cooper.
Here's the pitch. Not his best effort that time. It's strike one. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Oh, they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. That was a nasty looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
Standing in now, Adam Duvall. As he'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. His career batting line with Patrick Corbin. He has 7 hits in 19 tries. He's taken him deep once. Heading out towards shallow right. Long run for the right fielder. He can't get there as it falls in.
Well, that's what's so disappointing as a pitcher, Nero. You make a really good pitch, and yet this guy's so big and so strong, he's able to muscle it into right field for a base hit. Yeah, you hand your batting gloves to the first base coach right there, and you thank your lucky stars. That's a nice AB.
At the plate, Jorge Alfaro. And this one's in the dirt. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Yeah, and just one pitch after giving up the base knock, he uncorks a wild one and allows him to go to second. That's like giving a guy a double that he didn't even earn. That'll drive you crazy when you're on the mound.
Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Bottom part of the zone, a good changeup gets the call. Duvall leads off second with one gone in the inning. Nearly got the inside, but ruled the ball. The 2-1. Up the middle, and that's through into center field. Base hit, long throw to the plate, and they're not going to get him as he's in there to score.
That was a nasty sinker right there. Sometimes you get a little luck on the offensive side. Definite ground ball with eyes right there.
At the plate now, Miguel Rojas.
Ball one, no.
As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. Runner at first here, one man out. Slider, but that's below the knees, and it's 2-0.
Well, he's not proving that he can command his breaking ball in the zone right now, and until he does, there's no reason to bite on it.
Two and one.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Grounded down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. Line drive, base hit. Throw into third. Oh, and he's not going to make it to third as he's gunned down by the right fielder, and that's a tough second out.
Anytime you're going for third, you want to be really sure you can get there because you know you're already in scoring position standing on second base to begin with. He almost made it work because it ended up being a close play. But, man, those outs at third are tough to swallow.
So now to the plate, Pablo Lopez. And he's a bit tardy there on the first pitch fastball. It's nothing and one. Here's the 0-1 pitch.
Down 0-2, maybe simplify the game plan right here. Get on the heater, even though he has five weapons to go to.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. So one run on three hits, no errors, and one man left on. So here is Patrick Corbin.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
First delivery to him.
Count 1-0.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
Well, there's the great equalizer, the change of El Cambio. Listen, if you can keep that pitch in your back pocket and pull it out when you need it like he did right there, usually hitters, they don't stand a chance.
Stepping in now, number 81. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. 0 for 1 here in the early going. Up top, it's 2-0. One out, nobody on. And that one yanked just foul. The 2-1 home. Hit in the air down the right field line. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. So the next to bat will be Victor Robles. He singled in his first AB. And now pitch on the way. As with two away, he'll swing and miss at the first pitch. It's 0-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. Counts even at 1-1 to Victor Robles.
Hey, a two-out walk right here would be the tying run to the plate. Even though it's early on, you got a guy on deck that has a lot of pop.
Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Three up, three down for Washington. They're still down. It's 2-0. Into the box, Jazz Chisholm worked a walk his first time up.
The second baseman.
Now here it comes.
0-1.
And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
That was a great job of driving that ball. Extending his arms very well, was able to get it over the right fielder's head. One hopping it off the wall for an easy double. That's one of those solid hits that you don't even feel coming off the bat.
In now, John Birdie. As the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Here it comes. Strike called. Now the throw down. Not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw.
You know, I was pretty surprised to see him on the move to third because it didn't seem like he had that much of a lead, but he made it work out. That was really impressive.
Has a look. Now the pitch.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well three times in a row with off speed.
The 0-2 once more. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right.
He was looking for a swing and a missed breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
Another 0-2 coming. And it's fouled away. Runner at third here, nobody out. Down the third baseline. Oh, and he can't come up with it.
The center field, number 27. Mark. Wow.
Here's the center fielder, Mike Trout. He swings and sends a bullet to right field. Catch made here in medium deep right center, and the runner's breaking from third. And not in time as the run scores.
Boy, this one looked like it was headed for extra bases off the bat. Instead, a line drive bullet caught in the alley, but he does end up getting a sacrifice fly.
Nick Castellanos now, as he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner. It's 0-1. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. And And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. Now a throw over to first.
No, he's in there.
And there he goes towards second. Pitch misses low. The throw down. Way late, and he's in there easily at second.
That's pretty savvy base running, right? A lot of pitches don't throw over twice in a row, so I think he was going on first movement, and it worked out nicely.
Hit hard toward the right side. And this is going to be a fair ball as it'll head to the corner. And this will find a wall deep in the corner. As he arrives at second without a play, as also on the play, a run comes across to score.
Yeah, when a pitching coach goes to the mound this early, he's probably just looking to reset the pitcher's mindset, get him to forget about the negative, and give him something positive to focus on. We'll see if he responds.
And that'll bring in Garrett Cooper as he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Comes set with the 0-1. Swing and a flare hit toward right. Here comes the right fielder. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Digging in will be Adam Duvall, runner in scoring position with Sugan.
Duvall.
Now here's the first offering. And he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one.
Hey, the way this guy on the mound's been struggling to find the zone, I'm not mad at the guy taking a pitch.
And one delivery off the plate. One ball, one strike. Two out here and a runner at second. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. Robles has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Three innings complete. It's the Marlins 4 and the Nationals nothing. Matt Baskerzin back with Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, and starting out the inning, the exciting speedster Trey Turner. Fiftieth pitch of the game on its way. Turner stands 6'2", as you see him in the right-handed box. He was a first-round pick during the 2014 draft.
Yeah, Matt, you cannot miss on your first rounder, and they didn't with this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar.
Now the 1-1 pitch is laid off for ball two.
I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
The 2-1 home.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
And he lays off their ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Well, he loses him there, but that's just the first walk he's given up, along with a couple of hits. So his command has been pretty solid so far.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Josh Bell, 1-for-1 with a single so far. And And now the first pitch. And a pitch out. Nothing doing, though, and that's ball one.
He's going. He's
Turner's
going.
On his horse on his way to second. Pitch is high. The throw. Not in time as he steals second. Certainly a very close play at second on that bag. So let's analyze it with show track. We all know he's got plus speed on his side, and you really see it represented in the top speed. That really made the difference on that one. Now the 2-0 home is swung on and missed. Strike one.
That's an impressive pitch right there. If you're willing to throw a changeup on 2-0, that tells me that's a pitch you feel really confident with.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Swing and he pops him up. And that's going to land foul. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
And he just manages to get his hand in. Josh Harrison stands in as he'll take a changeup here for strike one. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. And it's 1-1. Now a spin and a throwback to second, and he'll dive back in safely. Now the 1-1 pitch.
No touchdown.
Behind the runner at second and a dive, but he's back in there. The 2-2. No runs, two hits, and no errors so far for the Nationals. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Well, his struggles continue. It's been a rough go of it at the plate with him, and watching this at bat, it's clear to me that his rhythm and timing, they're just all off. Even as a pitcher like I was, you can tell these things and exploit them.
To the plate now, Hernan Perez. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing and one. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Hard hit ball to second. Beautiful diving stop. He gathers the throw. Got him. Three thumbs up here in the booth following this gorgeous play at second base. The three of us return with more Wednesday Night Baseball after this. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Don Mattingly about the Marlins' offensive production. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. They've already put four runs on the board, and they've done so by running up their opponent's pitch count. So he said he thinks they're going to have a lot more opportunities to score because of that as the game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And now it'll be the catcher, Jorge Alfaro. First pitch of the AB now. As he'll take a look at a sinker here, too low for ball one.
Well, it's been a rough one so far. Four runs through three innings. It's about time to get that pitch count down, or he won't be out here very long.
Hit on the ground down the first baseline. Bell brings it in, and he'll step on first for the out. Three unassisted. Next to hit, Miguel Rojas. He singled first time up. And the pitch. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
1-1. Ball back outside.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And he'll reach second now with one away. You can relate, Dan. So what's going through the pitcher's mind right now?
They've had some good at-bats against him all game long. It seems like it's just been hard hit after hard hit. As we take a look at his line here, the numbers do not lie. This has not been one of his better outings, and he'd be the first to tell you that.
Standing in now, Pablo Lopez, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Struck out in his first at bat. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Hit on the ground out to short. Turner has it. Throw gets him. Two down. Now to bat, Jazz Chisholm. He doubled his last time up. First pitch of the AB now. Ready with the nothing and one pitch.
Nope.
Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
Great game plan so far by this offense. They're not chasing any of those breaking balls out of the zone.
Oh, and a half swing there on a pitch out of the zone. Indeed, it's strike two. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. To two balls and two strikes now.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch until he proves he can lay off of it.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away. John Birdie would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Two pitch, and that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with two out.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that with too much.
Into the box, John Birdie, as he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. A hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Ready with the 1-0. 1-1 the count now. fires a pitch swung on and missed. One and two now.
I wouldn't be surprised if he uses his aggressiveness against him right here. If you're going to get a swing outside the zone, 1-1, might as well fish a little bit further.
Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
Man, that's a great take right there. Backdoor slider just missed the outside corner. This guy must have a really good eye. Most guys swing at that pitch.
Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Four runs, seven hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. This one is fouled away up to the concourse area. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Robles waits on it, and he's got it for the final out of the frame. Marlins strand a pair. They lead it 4-0. Welcome back to Miami as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point.
And flat out, he told me they just need to put better swings on the ball right now. He said they're searching for ways to drive the ball with some authority because it's just not happening for them today. They haven't gotten an extra base hit yet, so it's been a real struggle getting guys into scoring position. But the key, he said, is not to panic. Sometimes you just have to fight through the downturns and keep your focus and energy high.
Okay, thank you, Heidi.
The second baseman, Carter Huber.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. He swings and sends it in the air out to left center. Trout has a read on it. Makes the play, one away.
Now batting.
And now for Washington, Mac James struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Gotta find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Bases are empty, one man out. And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth.
Well, he's really locked in at this point in the game on the bump. So far this inning, four pitches and two outs. Got the first guy on one pitch, then absolutely dominates this at bat with a three-pitch strikeout.
Juan Soto will pinch hit here with two outs and the bases empty.
Number 22, Juan Soto.
First offering on its way.
That's a ball.
He's carrying a batting average of just over 300, so clearly he's been a productive player with the bat in his hand so far. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. Checks his swing, but this pitch is right there for strike one. Lifetime versus this pitcher, he has an even 10 hits in 25 tries. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him.
One
ball
and
two strikes now. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And he struck him out. His eighth punch out of the ball game, and that one ends the inning. Nationals gone in order. They trail here 4-0.
Just bounce it. Everybody wanna come, I'm announcing it. I'm always gonna get it, I'm always gonna get it. Even if it's
Joe Ross, 6'4" right-hander, comes in out of the bullpen to do the pitching.
Number 41, Joe Ross.
Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and standing in, the ever dangerous Mike Trout.
Smart. 12.
First pitch coming. Here it is.
Ball. That pitch is out.
Lays off again, and it's 2-0.
You never want to fall behind as a pitcher, but doing it to a guy like this is even worse. He's got to bear down and execute for the rest of this at-bat, starting right now.
Over the outside half, and it's 2-1. Ross, a 6-foot-4-inch right-hander, was selected in the first round back in 2011.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on a superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go into high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
That gets down and he's got himself a base hit. With that, the Marlins get a good start to the inning with their leadoff man aboard. Just an absolute laser that time, screaming off the bat, if you will. And ShowTrack tells us it went out at 112 miles an hour. Those are the line drives you can hear as they go by. Nick Castellanos at the plate now, as he'll take a look at ball one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Good swing, just got to try and straighten that one out. Here's a look over to first. Throw is up the line as it gets away. The 1-1 takes a pitch for strike number two.
One ball, two strikes.
A runner at first with no outs here. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Popped him up. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one.
Now back.
Next up, Garrett Cooper. He struck out and flied out. 0-for-2 so far. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. As he will take a look at a fastball in there as that strike zone expands just a little. It's 0-1. 1-1. Now the count to the Marlins first baseman. Runner goes for second. Pitch inside the throw. Perfect throw, and they got him at second.
Wow, that's a big-time throw right there, and it's a tall task to throw him out stealing a bag, but he got rid of it quickly, and it was a good job down there applying the quick tag. They'll have to feel good about that.
Now the 2-1 pitch. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. Nothing doing for the Marlins, but they hold a 4-0 lead.
Leading off for Washington, the left fielder, number 81.
Now the first pitch. Number 81 stands in as he looks at a called strike.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, But the bottom line is he's getting outs.
I got one ball,
and
one
here's
strike.
A curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1.
Ball
fastball just missed above the zone. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Popped him up. Birdie over to his right. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now batting.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder, and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop out. Well executed pitch there.
Victor Robles digging in now. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. A hit and two tries for him so far. Now the 1-0. Hit out towards second. And very quickly there, they're two gone to start the inning. Speedy Trey Turner digs in now. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. As he lays off a fastball too low for ball one.
Boy, they've been just getting shut down right here. Been a while since they've even had a runner on. So I think it's time to start looking for ways to make some things happen. Drop a bunt, get up on the plate, something.
Into his windup, here comes the 1-0.
Ball two
now.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
Two and one after the foul ball there. Into the windup and the pitch. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. The 2-2.
3-2.
Two out, nobody on. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Washington. They're down 4-0. And now, Adam Duvall. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far.
The left fielder, Adam Duvall.
First offering on its way. Now the 0-1. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. So one gone now as we give you a look at where these two teams find themselves entering play in the National League's Eastern Division race.
Alvaro.
Stepping in once again is Jorge Alfaro. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. First offering. And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul strike one. The windup and the 0-1.
Hey! No balls, two strikes. Ball one.
Going to need to make a little bit of an adjustment with his slider release and at least tempt the hitter that it's going to be a strike.
Here comes the 1-2. Sent on the ground out to second. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first. Two gone. Now to the plate, Miguel Rojas. He doubled his last time through. First pitch coming. Here it is.
Ball, that's
it. Bases are empty here with two men out. And that's in there for his strike 1-1.
Ball.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1.
Nope.
He's fallen behind now. 3-1.
3 balls, 1 strike.
Fouled away. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Marlins, but they're in front 4-0. So that'll bring up Josh Bell, 1-for-2. He singled and struck out in two trips. 19. Josh Bell. Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball one.
Good change up there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one. And maybe a little frustrated on the mound here as the fastball misses for ball two now.
2-0 to a guy with this kind of pop, you better be awfully careful because he's going to be swinging out of his shoes.
Now Bell swings and launches one to right. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo home run here off the bat of Josh Bell, and even 20 home runs for him now thus far. As they get on the board, it's 4-1 now.
What a great feeling right there as he circles the pillows, finally able to get this offense potentially going with one swing of the bat, being shut out all game, but not anymore.
Into the box now, Josh Harrison. As he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. No hits to this point. The 1-0. Hit on the ground to short. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. Riding in now for the Nats, Hernan Perez. One run in and one gone so far this inning. First delivery to him. Fouled off. One out, nobody on. And he misses with it, 1-1. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Into the windup and the pitch.
Ball three.
Shin high fastball that time, ball three.
Down to 3-1.
And this
ball
misses
four,
here for
low.
Ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work.
And don't forget, he gave up a long ball earlier in this inning, so you can understand why he wasn't too aggressive with him there. When he got him to 3-1, he wasn't too anxious to challenge him.
Shane Green will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Jacob Stallings is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Carter Keboom digs in now. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. One there, but one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue. Next to hit is Mac James. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. First pitch of the AB now. Hit hard to the right side, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. one in the inning for the Nationals on the solo home run. Get up and stretch. It's the Marlins 4 and the Nats 1. Jacob Stallings will be the next hitter. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number 7. Pitch on the way.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
The 0-1 on its way. A bouncer up the middle. Scooped up. And the throw to first is in time. One gone. So now into the box is Jazz Chisholm. It was a walk in his last trip. Here's the first pitch to him.
Inside, ball one.
Obviously, the game plan wasn't to let this guy beat you right here. He's already walked twice, and that pitch out of the zone tells me they want nothing to do with him.
1-1 to the Marlins leadoff hitter. Line to short, but gobbled up there, and there are two away.
The third baseman, number 5.
Now it'll be John Birdie. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. The 0-1 pitch.
Off the plate, ball one.
We're in the 7th now. 4-1 our score to this point. Outside, 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Hit on the ground to third. Throw on the belt at first, and the side is retired. Miami down in order as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. Dylan Floro has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the 8th.
Number 36, Dylan Floro.
Joey Wendell is going to be asked to get things going here as a leadoff the top of the 8th. First offering on its way.
Ball, that's out.
He'll start this one at 274. 18 homers, 56 runs batted in. Now the 1-0. Finds the zone, strike one. Lifetime in this matchup. He's 1-for-3. The 1-1.
I got 2-1 account.
And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
If you're at the plate in this situation, you're only thinking one thing, and that is get on base. You got three balls. It has to be perfect over those 17 inches for you to pull the trigger. A walk is as good as a knock right here.
And a good take there will net him a base runner as it's ball 4 now to start the 8th inning. Stepping in next, number 81. He's 0-for-3 so far, so he hasn't done much to help at the top of the lineup. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Swing and a liner. But he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is hauled in for the first out.
Now batting, the center fielder, victory.
Next up is Victor Robles. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. First pitch on its way. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
Can't come out of his game plan right here. He knows he's a known sinker baller. I know it was a four-seamer right there, but get back to that two-seam. It's what his MO is.
The 0-1 pitch.
Ball, that's just out.
That misses. 2-1 the count now to the National center fielder. Swing and a miss. 2-2 now.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. Castellanos is over to his right as he puts this one away. 2 down. So it's a runner at first with 2 men out, and that'll bring up one of the fastest players in all the land, Trey Turner. From the stretch.
Nope. Outside.
Eighth inning. 4-1 is our score. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
If you've been paying attention, the guy on the mound does not want to come inside. If I'm at the plate, I'm leaning out over.
2-1, the count to Trey Turner.
Hey, you get 2-0, your eyes light up, but you're sitting in one spot, and he obviously didn't get it right there. But he still finds himself in a 2-1 count, ready to do some damage.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. 2 strikes on him now. Line to left. Duvall gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. So it's no runs on no hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Home half of the eighth, straight ahead. The Marlins on top, 4-1. Ryan Harper is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 33, Ryan Harper.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Mike Trout.
The center fielder, Mike.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch.
You know, some guys just don't like pulling the trigger in an 0-0 count. They don't like the ambush tactic. They like to calibrate the speed, maybe pick up the break. They want to know everything your ball does before they pull the trigger.
0-1 count. Here's the pitch.
That's out.
When the guy on the mound has complete command of his off speed, especially his changeup, sometimes as a hitter, you just have to give up pull side to stay on it.
Late making contact on that swing, and will do it again on 1-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
This pitching staff has done a really good job against this guy in this series. This is a really good hitter, and it's not easy to make a guy strike out 5 times in a series up to this point, but that's what they've done to this guy so far.
Stepping in now, Nicholas Castellanos, as he'll swing and miss at a first pitch slider at strike one. In his last at bat, he popped out in foul ground. The 0-1 pitch. So back-to-back sliders for strikes. Does he come back with yet another?
Hey, that's back-to-back really good sliders. I wouldn't be surprised if he threw another one right here. Looks like he's got that slide ball in his back pocket right now.
He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
In now, Garrett Cooper. And he fouls this one off. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. The 0-1. Did in the air out to left. Left fielder giving chase. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Marlins, but they lead it 4-1. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Roberto Osuna comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Bell. He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point.
Listen, it's not easy coming back off closers, but this guy hasn't been super dependable so far this season, and he's blown several saves up to this point.
Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike.
Hey, you want someone sometimes to rattle the bat rack, but also the guy on the mound's got to eat too. They're executing their pitches out there. It's going to be tough to score some runs.
0-1, here's the pitch. Swing and a miss, and he's in control. 0-2.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour. But it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. And he popped him up. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. Gone into the home bullpen for a home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His second home run of the game. And the Nationals are right back in it. It's now a 4-2 score.
That, my friends, is a cardinal sin for any closer. You can't give up the long ball. Good thing for him, he still has the lead. We'll see now if he can rebound and actually keep it.
So now to the plate, Josh Harrison. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Ready with the 1-0 pitch.
Oh, that's inside.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
That lays off, and it's 3-0. No outs, nobody on. Harrison in front, three balls and a strike.
Now this guy's got some of the nastiest stuff in the game, and it is absolutely no fun for an offense to try and piece together any type of attack when he's throwing this stuff.
Down the left field line and deep, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. Three, two pitch. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Not too often you see an at bat go from 3-0 to a strikeout, so that's a pretty good job on the mound right there. Kind of nice that he got a free strike on the 3-0 take, but he still had to put it in the zone.
standing in now, Hernan Perez. As he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1. 0-2 for him to this point. Ready with the 0-1. Swing and a miss, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
When I broke into the league, not many guys were throwing that elevated fastball with that much velocity on it. The game has changed.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
This tells me a lot about this guy. He's done a real nice job bouncing back from that home run to strike out the next two guys. Sometimes you're going to get taken deep, but it's all about how you respond that really matters.
At the plate now, Carter Kieboom. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
This thing stays in the park, but let me tell you something. He absolutely crushed this thing. This park is no bandbox. It takes a lot to get one out of here, and he almost does it. It carried a long time and hit it halfway up the wall for a long double.
Digging in next, Mac James. He represents the potential tying run if he can launch one or find a way around the bases.
Yeah, Matt, I kind of doubt he's thinking about going yard, even though that would be the best result they could hope for. He's not a long ball threat, and he knows it, so he could just be looking for some way to keep that line moving.
First delivery to him. And the pitch is off the catcher's glove as it rolls away. And the recovery will not be in time as he's into third on the passed ball. 1-0 pitch on the way. That swung on and missed, and we're even at 1-1.
Hey, this offense has this closer in trouble right here. They have to find a way to keep applying pressure. I don't know, everybody pop step in the dugout. Get on this guy and make him nervous.
Now the 2-1. And this will be a called strike two. And trouble now as they're down to their final strike tonight. And now this relatively sparse crowd comes to their feet one final time. And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible time run to the plate but could not cash in.
Well, that's not exactly how you draw it up. He gave up the long ball to make it interesting, but it was the only run he gave up, and he hangs on to collect a save.
4-2 the final score tonight. Miami jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Pablo Lopez records the victory, his 13th of the year. Patrick Corbin is only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. Roberto Osuna closes the door for the save, his 47th of the campaign. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Dozak, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, @MLB The Show.